Hello everyone, this is Viji. In this video, we are going to learn about exploratory data analysis and explanatory data analysis using Tableau. Understanding the context is the common step for both analysis. The audience for the exploratory data analysis is typically the analyst themselves and internal team members, and it is about what do you do to understand data. There are several ways to conduct exploratory data analysis. Let's look at few steps. Start with the observation. Then find the missing values. Categorize fields. And look how the data is distributed. Identify relationship in it. Then locate outliers and decide what to do with those. The ultimate goal here is to figure out what might be noteworthy to highlight to the audience. And the audience for the explanatory analysis could be anyone. And it is about what you do to explain the findings. How to present it? Choose an appropriate visual display. Eliminate clutter. Focus attention where you want. Think like a designer. And then tell an exciting story with your data. We got one such story to share. It's the time of the year when the management of DQ Library wants to select one of the branch for the prestigious Library of the Year 2021 award. The award should be selected based on two metrics. The award will be presented with a focus to motivate all employees, and during the same event, management want to set a realistic target for 2022 expenditure. Let's jump in Tableau and connect to the dataset. Starting with the observation, there are 6 fields and 59 rows. Let us scan the dataset to look for null values. Only one null value found for the branch B0387. Let's open the data source and update it with the reasonable estimate. Save and close the Excel file. Coming back to Tableau, click Data, refresh data source. The data set looks complete. Let's go to the worksheet. Tableau has automatically categorized the fields as dimensions and measures. Let us look at the distribution. Drag branch number to row shelf. Active library card holders to column shelf. Fit height. Sort the branch number by various fields to look at the data distribution. Is there a consistency between active library card holders and population served? Let us sort by number of in-person visits. There is something not right about B0157 branch. Let us create scatter plot between population served and in-person visit to see the correlations. Add a trend line. Clearly, this data is an outlier. How come the number of visitors is 4 times more than the population served? Something fishy. Let's exclude it for now. At this point, the analyst team should document all work including assumptions and hand over to the next team that will take over the project. This completes exploratory data analysis activity. The next phase is calculations, which we have already seen in other videos. So let's jump to the results directly, the rankings. The Library of the Year 2021 award. B0088 branch is the winner. We got the result now. Can we release the branch number to all employees? Hold on. Explanatory analysis starts from here. Let's start with developing an appropriate visual that focuses on message, follows the function, and that is not cluttered. we looked at several options: tables, vertical bar, and packed bubble. Packed bubble seems to be the appropriate visual for this purpose, as it displays all branch names clearly. Let's see how the packed bubble chart is developed. Create a new sheet. Drag branch name and rank overall to row shelf. Click table. Click packed bubbles. Looks good, but it displays only few branch numbers. But we want to display all branch numbers. Let's double click rank overall in mark shelf and add 200 and minus sign in front of it. This tweaking helps to bring the size of the bubble almost same. Now all branch numbers are visible. It looks great, right? Let's make the visual more functional. Add all ranks to the detail mark. Color looks bright. Let's modify it so that the branch number stands out. Let's add the worksheet in the dashboard. Add all three ranks as filters. The cool thing about this dashboard is the interactive packed bubble chart. You can eliminate one branch every countdown to create excitement among employees. I like it. We got the appropriate visual. Next is the story time. First step here is to list all contents that we want to share to the employees. Next step is to arrange them in a sequence. Let's start with the appreciation and close the event by setting a realistic goal for the team. Let's develop an interactive box and whisker chart for the goal setting purpose. Open a new sheet. Drag branch number, rank, overall, and expenditure per person to the row shelf. Select box and whisker plot. Let's move the branch number to the details mark. Fit width. Select axis and uncheck include zero. We are all set here. Let's create a new dashboard and drag the box and whisker chart. Add rank overall as filter. Select only top 5 performers to set a target for 2022. The target for all the branches in 2022 is the median expenditure of $40 per person served. We can then close the event by saying thank you. 5, 4, 3, 2, and the winner is you. Learning is fun.